Hello, my name is Carsten Schmidt-Weber. I want to briefly report about the Spitzing Lake meeting. This meeting was supposed to take place at this beautiful lake, but due to the COVID-19 conditions, it took place online and was supported by EIT Health, funded by the European Community. This was about the molecular airway analysis and biomarker developments, which are an important area not only for COVID-19, but also for other airway disease. The speaker from all over the world reported about exciting progress. Jose Ordovas at the Children's Harvard Medical School reported about differentiation stages of basal cells and their ability to tell us something about the disease in that case of chronic polyps, but he also showed data about COVID-19 and ACE2 expression. Also Herbert Schiller from Munich, the Helmholtz Center, reported about AT2 cells and particularly keratin 8 cells being in the middle of several differentiation states and their ability to commit to different cell maturation conditions. Andrew Bush from Imperial College at the Royal Brompton reported about the need of early life diagnosis and the use of corticoids, which is still a problem, and you want to avoid that. And I think here in this image, the eosinophils are showing as an example. The need here is, I think, still the same like for a long time ago, and he really emphasized the need for also for non-invasive diagnosis. Also Kerstin Meyer presented coming from the Sanger Institute at in Cambridge, reported single cell analysis data and showed also very fascinating data on of spatial transcriptomics, showing also the localization of gene expression to chondrocytes in the lung, which were rather exciting. Adam Chaka from the Technical University in Munich showed in vitro infection models and options for treating COVID-19 using existing drugs in the renin kinin system, and also on the next day showed how actually sampling devices for the upper airways are used. Ryan Trace jumped in for Peter Openshaw, who couldn't attend the meeting. He showed biomarkers that are applicable for the prediction of the severe progression of COVID-19, in that case IL-6, but also angiotensin, which was exciting because it came from a very large proportion population cohorts, where more than 2,000 patients that were collected in the ESARIC cohort. Yeah, and Ulrike Protzer from the Technical University Institute for Virology reported about the development of vaccination and the current standing and how governments actually supported the progress. This was very much appreciated by the audience. And I myself reported about biomarker and particular nasal secretions, which were used in allergen-specific immunotherapy. Here an example, R24, which was very successful in terms of feasibility, but also in terms of diagnostic power. Klaus Rabe reported about the different asthma phenotypes and how they are addressed by current biologics, and here particularly flagged up the needs for biomarkers of non-type 2 asthma phenotypes, whereas type 2 is better covered by several biomarkers already. Last but not least, Charles Pillay reported about the polymeric IG receptor, its mechanisms and its biology. Also here it was interesting to see that in different conditions these receptors play a different role, for example, also in cystic fibrosis or also in other chronic diseases such as COPD. Taken together, I think this was a very exciting meeting and we had a very positive feedback from the audience. I would like to thank the participants and you for your interest.